Hydrosphere. It is the realm of the water. It has various types of water bodies like rivers, lakes, seas, and oceans. For thousands of years, it has been raining. The water in the seas and oceans never dries up. Only less than 1% of water is useful to human beings. Is it enough for the human beings? Know the answers for these questions. Let's know about the hydrological cycle. Water goes through a cycle from ocean to land and land to oceans. It has been going for billions of years, and all the living things depends upon it. This hydrological cycle is the circulation of water in different forms. Liquid, solid, and gaseous phases are there. Thus, water is a cyclical, renewable resource. It can be used and reused. The cycle is expressed as RF is equal to RO plus ET. RF means rainfall, including all types of precipitation. RO is runoff water. ET is evapotranspiration. Water cycle has 6 stages. First one is the evaporation, transportation, condensation, precipitation, runoff, groundwater. Evaporation is a process by which water changes from liquid to gas. Sun heats up and evaporates the water from the water bodies like lakes, rivers, and oceans. When sun warms up or heats up the water, thus water is transferred from Earth's surface to atmosphere. Plants also allows water to the air through the transpiration process. Transportation. The movement of water through the atmosphere over the ocean to over land in the form of clouds is called transportation. And clouds are moved from one place to another place with the help of the upper air circulation or the sea breezes or the land breezes, etc. Condensation. In this process, the transported water vapor is transformed into tiny droplets and clouds. The clouds are formed here. Precipitation. It is a mechanism for transporting water from the atmosphere to the Earth's surface. And any type of precipitation from the clouds falls on the Earth's surface. This precipitation is in the form of rain, sleet, or snow. Runoff. The water which is returned by the precipitation flows down the hills, and some of the water is percolated into the soil and it recharges the groundwater, while the rest is flowing and returning the oceans where it is evaporated. Groundwater. Sometimes the groundwater can flow upward in the form of artesian wells. It flows slower than the runoff water. In the hydrological cycle, the water is circulated between the ocean, atmosphere, and the land, and there are number of subcycles also there. Water sources. Out of total water present on the Earth's surface, 97.2169% of water is saline ocean water. Only 2.7831% of water is fresh water. And in the fresh water also, large amount of the fresh water is in the form of ice and snow covered in the Antarctica and Arctic and in the mountain regions. Finally, only 30.1% of water is fresh groundwater. Only 0.34% of total amount of fresh water on the earth is in the form of lakes, reservoirs and river systems. This is only accessible for our needs. Oceans. Oceans and continents are the first order landforms. The large water bodies are called oceans, and the oceans are divided into 5 oceans like Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, it is also called as Antarctic Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. Millions of years ago, oceans were combined together as a single super ocean. It was known as Penthalassa. A sea is a body of saline water. Partly or fully, it is enclosed by land, and often it is used interchangeably with the ocean. Relief of the ocean. Like the land surface, we can find on the ocean basis different types of landforms like submarine ridges, plateaus, canyons and terraces. We can find within the oceans. The ocean floor is divided into 4 parts: continental shelf, continental slope, deep sea plain, and ocean deeps or trenches. Continental shelf. It is the border zone between land and sea, with a depth of up to 200 meters. It occupies about 7.6% of ocean area. The largest continental shelf is Siberian shelf in the Arctic Ocean. This continental shelf is important for fish wealth, crude oil, natural gas, and for building the seaports. Continental slope. The continental slope boundary indicates the continents. It is covered 15% of the ocean area, and it is complex relief. It has submarine canyons also. They are formed by the process of erosion of glaciers and the rivers. Deep sea plain or abyssal plain. These plains are gently sloping areas of ocean basin, and also these are the flattest and smoothest regions of the world. Their depth is varied between 3000 to 6000 meters. Oceanic deeps are trenches with a depth of 6000 meters. There are large narrow trenches, and they are not located in the middle of oceans. Mostly they are found very close to the continents, so these are helpful in the study of plate movements.